No.
Hey, welcome to Pavlog, your favorite dog channel. Today we are going to talk a bit more about raw feeding. Are you feeding your dog raw, or are you thinking about feeding your dog raw? What sort of raw diet are they having is important, because if you're feeding raw but you're not following the right ratio, it's actually worse for your dog. It's good to follow someone who has done the research and knowing what you are doing when you feed your dog, especially puppies and pregnant female dogs and female dogs feeding their babies. Currently, the two most popular models are Barf, B-A-R-F, stands for Biologically Appropriate Raw Feed, Barf, or Biologically Appropriate Raw Food. That's more like my kind of model. There's also another model which is quite popular, is PMR, stands for Prey Model Raw Diet, Prey Model Raw. That's why today we look into two of the most popular models, PMR and Barf, to see what are the differences. Actually, there's a lot of similarities. There are just some minor differences and different practices, but the ratio they give to their dogs, whether it's Barf or PMR, it's pretty much the same. And because they are popular models, there's a lot of people already using these models, and there's so much information you can find out, and there are also many support forums on internet. You can just log in and ask questions, and most of them will be very happy to help you for free. So that's why I think it's best, if you're thinking about raw feeding your dog, look into these two models.
Barf diet is based on a mix of raw meat, fruits, and vegetables. This diet is commonly made up with 80% meat, prefer mostly red meat. You can have chicken and stuff like that, but mostly red meat. 10% bones, meaty bones. 5% liver and 5% other secretional organs. There are some organs are considered meat, for example, heart and tripes. You know, green tripes are very good, but they are considered meat. When we talk about secretional organs, that's not liver. We are talking about things like lungs, pancreas, kidneys and stuff. If you feed too much of these organs, more than 5%, sometimes your dogs can get diarrhea. So make sure you measure them and mix them up so they are in the right ratio. You will see I measure all my raw feed in all the videos I make, because I'm feeding them the correct ratio. Because if you don't, it's actually bad for your dog. Certain vegetables give dogs energy and proteins. If your dog isn't getting the nutrients it needs, then some vegetables and fruits can come in handy. But there are sometimes you can feed them the wrong kind of vegetable and fruits that can be poison to your dog. Everybody probably know grapes is really bad, so don't feed your dog grapes.
My dogs eat grass.
Barf diet sometimes include kibbles and supplements, which I also follow that practice. Because of the limited resource I can get from raw food, I also feed them kibbles or supplements to compensate what I couldn't give to them from the sources I get. In conclusion, Barf diet is good for the dogs because they are natural and they are getting their energy and power from the raw meat without any artificial preservatives, color, or anything that could be bad for your dog. And this bonus nutrients from the vegetables can help. Just make sure you do freeze them. Dogs can get worms and stuff like that. They could die or they could get sick because there is parasites in the meat. So if you get your dog human consumption meat, make sure you freeze them for over a week. But if you buy them from a hunter or you hunt for yourself, make sure they are not hunting from a hunting zone where government or the farmers have been spreading some sort of poison to kill wild animals in the area. Otherwise, your dog could be eating like 1080 cyanide that can kill them. And also, if it's game meat, make sure you freeze them for more than 3 weeks. For my dogs, always more than 4 weeks, just to be safe.
Now let's talk about prey model. Prey model, it's a much more full-on, much more exotic method of feeding your dog. I found that it's actually very hard for people who live in cities, because for prey model, you're basically feeding your dog the whole thing. It's not very accessible for people living in cities to find the whole carcass, including the organs, hair, fur, everything, and skin animal to feed your dog. The intestines can be a part of the diet, so they eat whatever's inside the stomach if the dog wants to eat it.
It's much more accessible for farmers. They have their livestock, they can kill and feed their animals, or people who hunt and they carry the whole animal down to feed their dogs. It's exotic. I've got some clips here when I went to see some hunters, so you can see what I mean by that. And it's quite, be warned, the next image is a bit more graphic. It is graphic. Prey Model Raw, which is even more exotic. It's designed to provide family dogs with a homemade diet that replaces the diet of a wild canine. The ratio is known to be balanced, and it is similar to a kill of a wild prey while eliminating all the processed foods and grains from kibbles. The difference between Barf and PMR is Barf diet feeds supports eating some vegetables, fruits, or supplements, but Prey Model, since it's Prey Model, it does not. Prey Model often feeds the whole animal to a dog, feed them whole. So I'm talking about including hair, head. I'm talking about everything, right? It keeps the ratio. So we talk about that 80-10-5-5 ratio. That's pretty much a ratio of a whole animal. The ratio of a, you know, if you catch a rabbit or a deer, that's what's in an animal.
Some of them feed them the whole deer head, you know, with eyes and everything. It's a bit too much for me. But if you're interested, just search up PMR, and there's tons of information out there, and you can have a look for yourself.
Diet and nutrition is such a big topic. I mean, I don't think there's the perfect way to do it. Everybody's different. You know, some people are vegetarians, they do well. Some people love meat. So on a nutshell, that's what they are. They are very similar in a way, but one is more prepared than the other. I don't know what you guys are feeding though. I got a lot of people watching my videos feeding my dog. I love to hear what you feed your dog, and if anything that I've said is wrong or have I missed anything, put your comments down below, because it could be very helpful. Be constructive. Don't hurt each other while you express what you think is perfect. This is a very debatable topic, very, very debatable. And in my opinion, you just have to find out what is the best for your dog. I don't think there's one size fits all, one way to feed your dog.
I hope this video is helpful. And if you have any questions, please just post it down below. And if you're already feeding raw, if there's anything I missed out, please let us know. And anything that I should be included in my next video or future video, please let me know. I would love to include them so people don't miss out.
Green tribe.
Wait, ox.
Oh, pig tribe. I don't know. It's called green.